Hello, and welcome to WingCast, a podcast about all things Goldwing. I'm your host, Rick Arnoldo, president of WingStuff.com and lifelong rider of the Honda Goldwing. In this podcast, we talk about the latest Goldwing news, speak with fellow riders and experts in the motorcycle industry, and discuss whatever else comes to mind. We'd love to have you join us. And today's guest is somebody that I've been following on YouTube, and I think a lot of you might have heard of him. And for those of you who haven't, I think you're going to really enjoy following his YouTube channel because he's a real great guy. And who am I talking about? Chris Caliente, welcome to today's episode of WingCast. How you doing, Chris?
Thank you, Rick. Thanks for having me on.
How did you get into Goldwings? Let's start there. How did you even get into Goldwings? When did that happen, and how did you start riding bikes? Tell us a little bit about how this all started.
Well, I actually been riding bikes pretty much my whole life. Before the Goldwing, I actually had a sports bike or a crotch rocket, and I kept that bike for a few years. I didn't travel on it. It was just local rides, just ride around Memphis, ride around town. Bike night on Beale Street, things like that. And I sold that bike and bought a Harley.
Okay.
So once I got on the Harley, man, it wore me out. It rattled, it shaked, it vibrated, man. It wore me out. And I would find myself coming home.
So you signed up for the gym. You're telling me you signed up for the gym.
Basically, you know. And so the Harley would rattle, it would shake. And looks good, sound good. But it wore me out. So, you know, at the end of my ride, I would come home and, you know, I would basically have to take some pain medication because my body was aching. Wow, so, you know, I'd come to the conclusion that either I'm getting too old to ride or I need to get a better riding bike. So I decided to get me a Honda Goldwing. So at the time I purchased my Honda Goldwing, or when I was in the market for a touring bike, I didn't know of anyone that had a Honda Goldwing. I mean, I knew about the Honda Goldwing because it had been around for many years, but I've never owned one. I didn't know anybody that actually had one. So, you know, I looked into which bike I wanted to buy. I looked at a Harley Ultra Classic. I looked at the Royal Style Venture. I looked at the BMW. I looked at just all of the touring bikes at the time, the Victory, I think it was the Victory Vision or the Victory Cross Country Tour. So I looked at the Victories, and I was in the market for a touring motorcycle. So I came across the Honda Goldwing, and I bought it because Honda had been around for many years, and I knew that their name had a good reputation. So I didn't know anybody. I bought the Honda Goldwing. And so once I bought my Honda Goldwing, I wanted to, you know, accessorize my Honda Goldwing. So I got on YouTube and I started looking around for, just looking around on how to, you know, fix on the Goldwing or add things to the Goldwing. And I could not find any videos on it. Now, I came across Cruise Man. A Cruise Man at the time, he was a motor vlog, and he was just putting accessories on the bike, like how to put lights on the bike or how to put, just an accessory on the bike. So I came across his channel, and it was nobody else out there. I looked and looked and looked, and I saw a bunch of young guys doing motor vlogs, you know, being silly on dirt bikes. And they were just being silly on motor vlogs. So I got to thinking, you know, I can do this. I can do this. And I've always been a hands-on kind of guy. I've always been the type of person that I can fix things myself. I've always knew how to figure things out. I've always been blessed with the ability to use my hands. So, you know, I got to thinking, I said, well, I'm going to start doing motor vlogs, and then I will add a twist to it by fixing up my Goldwing and motor vlogging at the same time. So, I started my YouTube channel, and you know, at the time, I never showed my face. I didn't want people to know who I was, because I've always been camera shy. I didn't want anybody to know who I was. So I kept it a mystery, and I started my channel. I think shortly thereafter, Memphis Mike bought him a Honda Goldwing, and he started doing some videos, and he actually looked me up and he reached out and wanted to meet. He wanted to meet me. So at that time I was like, you know, no one has ever reached out to meet me. So I think Memphis Mike was like the first guy that wanted to meet me. We connected, we became friends. We, you know, started hanging out. And so, thanks to Memphis Mike, my cover was blown. So
And he's a great guy.
He's a great guy. Really you know, you know, we thought he was, you know, we didn't know the guy was black, but so, you know, Memphis Mike was the one that kind of, you know, turned the lights on and exposed me. So, you know, I just been doing it ever since. And, the channel has been out since, 2014. And, I've now have about somewhere around 16,000 subscribers. Somewhere about maybe 4,000 or 5,000 on Facebook. I put out over 1,200 videos on YouTube. So it's just getting bigger and bigger. You know, it started out like a little grass fire, and it just bloomed into a stacking alarm. So
I hope it's not work for you. I hope you're still enjoying it.
I still enjoy it. I enjoy it.
All accounts.
And that's what it's all about, just having fun. They say if you're doing some things that you like to do, it's not work. So
And that wasn't a trick question, because I knew you were going to say you did. Because when I watch your videos, I can tell you're having a good time. That's that's the great part of your videos. You know, it's you're the real deal. I like that. And even Memphis Mike, you know, we have a lot of our customers that follow his channel too. He's got a great channel too. And he's a character. I like watching his stuff too. You know, so you are the you're the two guys that I noticed the most out there. And I really did enjoy your channel. That's why I thought of you for the podcast.
I think the first time I actually saw your video is, I may be incorrect, but I think the people at your office fixed up your Goldwing or something and added a bunch of accessories to it. And
we did a Goldwing makeover on my 2012. That's right. We did a video on that.
Yeah. Yeah. And that was the actually first time I came across your video. At the time I was looking, you know, well, I actually learned about the Centromatic wheel balancers watching your video. And you and you spoke very highly of the Centromatic wheel balancers at that time.
Absolutely.
And so after watching your video, I decided to buy some Centromatic wheel balancers, and I put them on my 2016 or the 2014 I had at the time. And and I've been using them ever since. As a matter of fact, I got some wheel balance right here that I bought from WingStuff.
There you go. Go WingStuff.
I bought them from WingStuff about maybe been a month ago. I'm going to put them on my 2100 Goldwing, you know, before it warms up, before the spring.
Those are the greatest things. I mean, there's no better balance and solution on the planet Earth for a Goldwing than Centromatics. And you know that already. I already know that you know that.
As you can tell, I have a tire machine behind me. So
there you go.
I don't have to worry about balancing because I use those Centromatic wheel balancers. And, you know, you were spot on. Your video was spot on the Centromatic wheel balancer. So after I saw your video, I bought the Centromatic for my 2014 and I got rid of the 14. I upgraded to the 16. I took those same wheel balancers and put them on the 16. And I love them so much that I bought some from WingStuff for my 2100 Goldwing. So very impressive.
I agree with you. You know what? And this isn't about Centromatics, but I would never have a wing without the Centromatics on it. That's how great they work. And as you know, all you do is you put the Centromatic balancing disc on your wheel and the tires are balanced for life. All you do is change tires. You never have to have wheel weights again. And the bike is like riding on glass down the road. Yeah. And it's a difference.
It was so smooth
all the time.
It was so smooth at the time, Rick, that and it's funny that you mentioned glass because it felt like I was riding on glass.
Yeah, it's just so smooth.
Yeah, it was really weird, you know, and it was the smoothest thing I've ever experienced. So I really love those Centromatics. If anybody want to watch my video on the Centromatic wheel installation, check out my YouTube channel. I have a video on how to install the Centromatic wheel balancers on the
That's a good
on the Honda
Goldwing. That's a great tip. Yeah, you know, if you have something on there, yeah, folks, check that out. You know, the nice thing in closing about that is, you know, the great thing about Centromatics is when you take your tires off and you're about to change them because they're worn out, your tires are balanced perfect right up until the end because the wheels are balanced.
Right.
Therefore, the tires are balanced. People don't realize that when they have wheel weights, by the time they take their tires off their bike, if you put that wheel on a wheel balancer, you would be shocked how out of balance that tire is. And nobody takes their tires off every 5,000 miles and rebalances them. They don't do that.
No,
and
not
that's
on a
why. You're right. That's the
put it this way, Rick. You know, when you leave the shop or the dealership and you have your tires balanced, they're balanced. But as the tire wears over time, you actually lose the balance because, you know, you're wearing off the rubber, you're wearing it down, you're wearing it down. And you actually lose the balance. But the beauty of the Centromatics is that it's always readjusting to balance the wheel. So you never
as you ride.
So as the tire wears down, it's a consistent balancing. And and the good thing is that it makes your tires last longer and it prevents the tire from cupping.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah, so I absolutely love them. So I recommend the Centromatic wheel balancers to all Honda Goldwing riders.
That's good information, and that's something that I like telling people about because I'm not trying to just sell them. It's like I'm trying to tell them about something that works unbelievably, and they don't even realize. They don't realize that when they get 5,000 miles on their brand new tires, and I pull that wheel off, it's not balanced anymore. And that's people look at me like, "What?" I guarantee you it's not balanced. Your tire's starting to wear. It's not balanced anymore. Centromatics, all the time they're balanced. Right up until the time you take that tire off, it's always balanced. As soon as that wheel starts turning, it balances the wheel.
And so, a lot of people may not know this. Yeah. They even make Centromatics for automobiles. They make it for tractor trailers. So
yes, they do.
You know, not just motorcycles, but I mean, I am highly impressed with the Centromatics that I picked up from WingStuff. I absolutely love them.
Well, I'm glad you know about them because you're informed. So hopefully everybody else pays attention because I would never have a wing without those. And I'm not just trying to sell those things. Those are the best things since sliced bread. I mean, talk about technology. Why do I want wheel weights? And then as my tire wears, it's got to balance. I got to rebalance it again. It's a no-brainer. Yeah. And you're not wrecking the tire because you don't have, I mean, you know, we sell the beads too, but honestly, I don't want beads running around inside my tire. Then you change the tire. You've got a handful of rubber sawdust and you know, it's not meant to be on an inside of a tire like that, you know,
that's true.
Definitely a better way to go. But moving on from that, and I'm glad you mentioned that because that's something a lot of people don't realize what they do. They hear that word Centromatic and it's like, what are those? Well, when they figure out what they do, it's a no-brainer. Why would you not put those on your bike? You know, it's like, but anyway, so you know, I like the background on how you get started and you've been doing this for a long time. Now, I see a lot of bikes in your garage. You know what? You have your 2016 and back you, it looks like.
Yes.
What's your favorite bike in that garage? Because I see a new one on the left. That looks like a, what is that, a 2021?
That's a 2021. Let me kind of back it up a little bit, Rick. Like I said, the first Goldwing I purchased was the 2014. It was the level one. And I absolutely loved it. I loved that bike. The thing about it is that it didn't have GPS. It didn't have ABS on it. And so 2 years later, when Honda came out with the 2016, they came back with the same color, which is the candy red. Yeah. So I said, you know, I should have bought the level three when I first purchased the Goldwing, but I was kind of being frugal and I purchased that level one. So when it came back out with it in 2016, I sold it and got this 2016 that's behind me. And you know, for a long time, for anybody that watches my videos, you know, I always say, you know, it's the most luxurious motorcycle in the world. Well, when Honda finally introduced the new Goldwing, you know, I wasn't a big fan of it, you know, because of a lot of the changes that Honda actually made. But after a few years of the new bike being on the market, I purchased this 21. So to get back to your original question, which one do I like the best? You know, I have my moments. Some days I like the older Goldwing better. And some days I like the newer Goldwing better. I mean, they're just two different bikes with two different attitudes. And you really, it's, to be honest with you, I tell people it's really hard to compare them, you know, even though they have the same name. It's actually hard to compare it. The older Goldwing is a big, comfortable, luxury touring bike, and you can just ride forever. I mean, it's easy on your body, especially for you know, a person that's getting up in the age and they can't take that beating, you know, like maybe from some of the Harleys, or they can't take that beating on the road. That 20 of the previous generation Goldwing is so comfortable, but is lacking in technology. When Honda revamped the Goldwing and came out with the new Goldwing, the 2018 plus Goldwing, I mean, you know, they added Apple CarPlay, they added Android Auto, they added the DCT engine, Hill Assist. So, you know, the electronic windshield, you know, the wireless key fob. So the newer Goldwing,
and 90 pounds lighter,
90 pounds lighter. And then the manual, the DCT, oh my God, it is just, it is smooth as butter.
I have a DCT too, so I agree with you. I love it.
So the newer Goldwing has the better technology.
Yes.
The older Goldwing is more comfortable. So it kind of depends on what type of ride I want to feel that day. If I want to get aggressive and I want to get the knee down, or if I want to, you know, I want to ride fast and ride hard, you know, I can't beat that new Goldwing. But if I just want to have a basic, comfortable ride, long distance, just comfortable without all the bells and the whistles, the 2016 is the better bike. So, you know, it changes daily.
I had both my Goldwings at Sturgis this past 2021 in August, and we'll have some videos coming out later on that we shot there. But when I had both of them out there, I took both my Goldwings out there and I was riding them, and I realized that my 2012 on the highway was super comfortable. Now, my new bike's comfortable on the highway, don't get me wrong, but the old bike is a little bigger, a little heavier. And like you said, on a long ride, you know, long distance ride, it's super comfortable. I really like it a lot. And I rode the new bike, my 2018 DCT. And I realized it was comfortable on the highway, but between the two of them, it was kind of like the difference with like one of those old big cars, like an old Cadillac that was heavy and you're riding and it's just so smooth. But once you start getting into those corners, the old Cadillac starts going like this, you know, know, the suspension. So it's kind of, it reminds me of that. So I love my new DCT, and between the two of them, it's my favorite, but I won't sell my 2012 because I still like it a lot. What a beautiful motorcycle, you know?
That's why I have both of them behind me, you know, and
there you go.
Shouts out to my friend Kimo out there in Virginia. He says the older Goldwing is a big El Dorado. He call it the L Dog. And we kind of laugh about it, but
yeah, you know,
I like them both. It changes from day to day. You know, here in the South, like right now, we have a temperature outside somewhere just below freezing or near freezing.
Man, I've been watching the news today. It's cold there.
The high today is supposed to be around 32 degrees, maybe just a little bit above freezing. And on the older bike, it has a lot of wind protection. So when you ride in the wintertime, you don't have all that wind hitting you. And so, you know, that's very important. As a rider, you know, because wind can actually make you fatigue, or it can actually make you cold, which it's uncomfortable on either side. So with the older Goldwing, you got a lot of wind protection. You don't have that, all that cold air hitting you. On the newer Goldwing, you got more air coming in. So in the summertime, I can see the newer Goldwing being a lot funner. Mm-hmm. Can I say that? A lot funner.
A lot more fun.
Yeah. In the wintertime, I can see the older Goldwing being better.
Yeah.
So it's really weird. It's kind of like a seasonal bike. Like the newer Goldwing is better in the summer, and the older Goldwing is better in the winter.
Right.
The older Goldwing is better on a longer distance ride, but the newer Goldwing is funner on a short adventurous ride. So I don't know. It changes day to day.
And there's also ways to fill that void between them, because if you had a new bike, a new Goldwing, and you wanted to get more wind protection, now you can accessorize it with a wider windshield. You can
put
wind wings on it. You there's things that you could do to make it like you want, as well as the older bike. But I agree with you that just out of the box, the older bike has more coverage because it's bigger.
Yeah, it's bigger, and it just keeps, you know, even on the newer Goldwing. And you guys could check out my video on that where I added wind deflectors, and they actually help. Yeah. It helps a lot. But yeah, I still can feel where the wind is coming in, hitting my hands, little things like that. But it's a fun bike. Right. I absolutely love it. And the DCT is perfect in those.
It's amazing.
In those high traffic areas, the stop and go. You don't have to worry about, you know, changing gears, you know, squeezing a clutch. You just move the throttle. So, you know, I absolutely love it. I love it.
Well, what we've seen in the past, we know the way Honda is. They're always going to push the envelope with technology, better braking, lighter weight, better handling. This is just a mindset. So you know that the bike, even in the future, will continue to be refined in a better way. They're never not going to make the bike better. It's always better. Now, they might change it a little bit. Now, that new bike, I would classify the new bike. The old bike was the best touring motorcycle in the world, as far as I'm concerned. The new bike still is. I consider it the best sport touring motorcycle in the world. Right. And it's just as good as that touring older model. But now, you know, with the lighter weight and the new design, sure, it's a little smaller. But boy, you could throw that thing around like a sport bike.
Yeah, it takes the bumps better than the older
girl. Yes, it does.
So the suspension is a lot better. So
absolutely,
you know, both of them have their advantages and disadvantages. And I'm like you, Rick. That's why I still have both of them. You know, I still enjoy both of them. So
one of the questions
that came up to me here recently, if I was going on a long distance trip, which bike would I take? You know, I don't know.
Think about it. It's exactly the same, like as cars. You know, cars continue to get smaller and better too. I mean, years ago in the 70s, we had those big Eldorados and the Cadillacs, and you know, and cars now, when you go and rent a car, if you're traveling, a full size car looks like a compact car nowadays,
compared to
the old days. You know, the old days, I get a big. Well, even the motorcycles, you know, these companies are making them better, lighter, sportier, but more comfortable. So, you know, it doesn't surprise me they did what they did. And you have the new trunk, too. You have the 2021.
So
you have
the big trunk. Got the big trunk on. I absolutely love it.
I have the smaller trunk, and I may try to upgrade just the trunk. And I'll tell you why. I would think about getting a newer model, but I have so much invested in time and money in my DCT, my 2018. I mean, we have everything done to that bike, everything that I like done to the bike.
Right.
So I feel like underneath it's the same bike, but that big trunk, I certainly like that. So it's going to be expensive, but I may end up updating it to the new trunk later on. It's, you know, we had a podcast with Fred Harmon last time, and Fred was sharing his thoughts on the new bike. And he says, he's not saying they're going to do this. He said, but you know, he doesn't know. Maybe they might make the saddlebags just a little bit bigger to complement the trunk, but we have no idea if they're going to do that. Another great thing that he said, and I agree with him, is this bike has really no issues. If you look at the history, not that the old Goldwing had issues, but over the years, you know, the 1800 came out in 2001, and the last year for that bike was 2017. Right. And there were some recalls, there were some things over the years. We've been into this new bike since 2018 now, and it's 2022.
Right.
And Fred commented on the fact that there really hasn't been any issues. He said, this is actually the first model that really has been issue free across the board, as far as anything like, you know, frame recalls or anything like that.
Right.
They've really got this bike dialed in. The only thing that I personally would like them to see do, and everybody is pressuring them, and it's been a few years now, is please fix the GPS.
On my 21 Rick, I have no issues with the GPS. Really? And the thing, okay. And the beauty of this new Goldwing is that with the Apple CarPlay, you just plug in your Apple phone.
Yeah, use your phone.
Mirror and mirror the GPS off your phone. So technically, sure. You don't even need to even use the Honda OEM GPS. You can use the one off your phone. But you mentioned about the earlier Goldwings. Yeah, they had some recalls like the whales. Sure. I think they had some weld issues where they had to go back and do some welding. I think they had a ground issue on some of the earlier Goldwings. I know they had a rear brake. Some brake caliper issues or brakes getting stuck on the previous Goldwing.
Over the years, we've had a couple of issues with the old ones and they were taken care of. But like you say, between the frame and some of the other stuff that was going on in the bike. Yeah, there was some issues. This bike is issue free.
I haven't had let me point this out, Rick. That's one of the reasons why I waited. Now, if people watched my video channel and when after Honda released that bike, I said that I wasn't going to get the newer Goldwing. I actually waited. I wanted to wait to make sure that they worked out any bugs or any issues. Because a lot of time when a product first hit the market, they got to work some of the bugs out. And even on the Phobos, and I'll get to that in a little bit, but I waited. You know, Honda made some of the changes. They made the trunk bigger. Updated that GPS. And so they worked out a few of the bugs and I haven't had any issues at all. I've had zero issues on my new Goldwing and I absolutely love it. I really do.
I love mine too. And I ran down, I was different than you when I saw it. I said, I got to have that. Yeah. And the GPS isn't a big deal. I mean, it works really well, but there's some features in there that they need to fix with software updates to make it behave better. That's the thing that's driving everybody crazy. Right. It doesn't do certain things that they want it to do. It's just a matter of some software updates. And they've had a few and they've made it better, but they still have a few more things to do to get it to where people like it. And I think that's going to happen through software updates.
I have yet to use my OEM Honda GPS one time. I just plug in my phone and use the Google Maps or use Apple Maps. So, you know, I guess it depends on your setup or what you're trying to accomplish, but I have no issues with that new Goldwing. I mean, other than wind protection, I mean, it's perfect. It's perfect.
I agree. It's the best motorcycle I've ever owned. And by the way, I do the same thing you do. I use my CarPlay all the time and I use my phone for GPS. It's just a habit. And the nice thing is, you know, Honda is addressing this bike and continues to do updates. They came out with the Android version of that as well, because when that bike was first released, it was only Apple.
Yes. And it came out with the Android Auto and it works fine. I have an Android phone and it works fine. It works fine. Yeah. You just have to connect your headset to the bike. Right. You have to pair your headset to the bike. And then once you plug the phone in, then it pops right up.
And you mentioned a little bit ago about fatigue. You know, this new bike is so easy to ride and it's light and I got my bike so dialed in with everything. It's just, I can ride that thing all day and I feel like I went for an hour ride. I mean, I just don't get tired on it. My 2012, almost that way. Just the new bike's just easier to ride. I think I get fatigued less with the newer bike for sure. But the older bike's comfortable too. As a matter of fact, I take it on the canyons and I throw that thing around. It handles unbelievable.
Right.
And prior to this new bike coming out, I think the Goldwing for sure was the best handling large motorcycle that I've ever ridden. The only one that I would compare it to would be the BMW, because I did like the BMW and I still do, but I prefer the Goldwing for sure. I just feel more comfortable on it. I was in New Zealand and I took a 2-week tour with a friend of mine, Fred Rao, that you might have heard of. He's been a moto journalist for so many years. He was ex-editor of Wing World magazine many years ago. He runs some tours in New Zealand and we teamed up with him and we ended up rounding up some of our customers that joined us on a tour in March of 2020. That's when COVID came out. But this is just before COVID was really hitting the news hard. And we were over there for 2 weeks. And every time we'd stop in a town, because it's so beautiful in the countryside, and we'd be watching the news of what's going on in the world. And it was like this COVID thing's going on, but we're in our little bubble. You know, we're traveling around New Zealand, and you know, I rode a BMW is the point I'm trying to make, and I had a 1200 RT, and boy, did I love that bike. So I'm a fan of Beamers. I like them, but if I had a choice, I love the Goldwing. It's definitely my pick for sure. You know,
I could have went out and purchased the Harley. I could have purchased the Yamaha All-Star Venture Transcontinental.
Yeah.
I could have purchased the BMW. I could have purchased, you know, any touring bike out there on the market, but I decided to go with the Honda Goldwing, and I do not regret my decision.
I agree with you.
You know, I think I made the right decision.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I know I made the right decision.
Sure you did. Yeah.
I have no regrets. I never look back. I'm happy with both bikes.
It's great. And,
you know, here I am.
And I'm like you. You know, I like motorcycles in general. I have a Harley. I have a 2016 Street Glide. And I just enjoy riding that bike around town. It's fun to ride, but if I'm going to go long distance, I'll be honest, with all respect, I would never take the Harley. No. I would take the Goldwing. There's no way. But if I'm just cruising around, even for a half a day or maybe a day ride, you know, that bike rumbles and it shakes, but that's what it's supposed to do. And
it's a Harley.
You know what it feels like? I'm going to describe it my own way. I feel like a Harley is a modern antique motorcycle.
Right.
That's what I feel like. And, you know, the technology is pretty good now. I got fuel injection on mine and I like it, but, you know, it's definitely more of a raw motorcycle. And that's what I enjoy about it. But if I want comfort and I'm going to take off for a day or a week, or I'm going to go cross country, could I do it on the Harley? Sure, I could. But there's no comparison. I'd be tired at the end of the day. You're fatigued. This Goldwing, you know it. We can go out there for two or 3 weeks and come back and feel great. I mean, it's just the smoothest, best bike out there to ride. So it's hard to compare. You really can't compare the two of them.
Yeah. And even for myself, I find myself jumping on my newer Goldwing now
more
than my older Goldwing. The heated grips get hotter.
Yeah.
The seat gets hotter. You know, so it's a fun bike. I really enjoy it, and I really love the DCT. I initially said I wouldn't buy a DCT, but at the time of purchase, I said I'm going to get this DCT, and I'm glad I did. So I tell all of my friends, if you're going to go out and buy the new Goldwing, get the DCT. Get the
DCT. Here's what's funny. When the bike came out, now they used DCT technology in some of their other Honda motorcycles prior to that. And I think they had it on some of their dual sport bikes too. But anyway, they put it on that bike and I was going to get the manual. I was going to get the 6-speed. And my guys told me, you got to get the DCT. It's the newest thing out. And I, you know, I have to admit, I was thinking kind of old fashioned. I said, you know, but I know it's new, but I like to shift. But I said, okay, I'll get the DCT. Let's try that. And once I rode that bike, I said, boy, am I glad I didn't get the 6-speed. Now, I wouldn't mind riding it. I love shifting. There's certain bikes that I wouldn't want DCT on, but this bike is just that DCT complements the bike. I get on mountain roads, and I know you'll agree with this, and I tend to be a little aggressive sometimes, safely aggressive, and I'm throwing this thing around in corners. And the nice thing I realized right out of the gate was I can go into a corner, leaned over, very aggressive, and halfway through that corner, I can shift up coming out of that corner, and I can shift up again when I'm exiting the corner. Whereas if I did that on a manual shifting motorcycle, it would break my rhythm and I'd end up in the bushes. Yeah. I mean, you can't shift halfway into a leaned corner when you get that bike over to the ground. This DCT is so smooth. I'm halfway into the corner, leaned over to the ground, and I just tap it with my finger, shift up, and it's smooth. There's no jerking. It just sounds like swish. Like all you hear is
And the beauty of it does it in reverse. So when you're coming into a corner hot, you're running too hard. If you let off the throttle, it's going to automatically downshift. Or you can just tap it two or three times and it's just going to downshift. If you tap it three times, it's going to go down three gears. Smooth as butter. It's not going to yank you. It's not going to throw you. Just as smooth. So, you know, it does it in reverse just as, you know, good as it does in forward or shifting up. So I really like that. I really like that. I'm glad I got the DCT.
I agree with you. And what I've done, I developed my own little things, my little ways to ride the bike that I enjoy. And I kind of tuned myself to the bike that I knew when it was going to shift. I take it out of automatic. I hit that gray button. I take it out. And what I do is I know when it's going to downshift. So I'll use those paddle shifters and I'll downshift and I'll be in control of the shifting.
Right.
So when I'm in those canyon roads, I very seldom have it in full automatic. I take it out. I put myself in charge and I'm downshifting, I'm upshifting, and I've gotten so good with those paddles that it's almost clockwork. And it's just so perfect. Like I've never ridden a motorcycle where I was shifting it so perfectly.
Right.
And it was that technology that gave me the ability to do that. So what I did is I'm the captain. I take the helm and I'm using that technology, and I've learned to tune myself to the bike that I know when the bike's going to shift. And depending on the mode I'm in, if I'm in sport mode or touring mode, I know when it's going to shift. I feel the power and I'm so in control. It feels like the bike and me are one. Did you ever get to that way on your new bike? Did you feel that way? Because I get that way on my bike.
And then when you make the slow speed parking lot maneuvers, if you're in, take it out of automatic and put it in a manual, it handles even better because now it's not trying to change gears. So if you're cutting rates or you're doing slow speed maneuvers, if you're just in manual, it's smooth as silk. It's smooth.
I agree 100%. So, I would encourage some of the people listening to this, try to play with that. I spent time with that bike really sharpening my skills, doing circles. I was like, my neighbors thought I was crazy. I have a wide street where I live. I was doing all kinds of things because I was testing it. And I agree with Chris. I will always take that bike out of automatic and I'll be in charge of the shifting. And I can do more better when I'm in control of that shifting than I can when it's an automatic. And the times that I do use the automatic is when I just kind of want to get lazy. I purposely want to be lazy. I don't want to shift. And I just get on there and enjoy the automatic. But, slow speed or canyon riding, I take it out. And I've never been so sure of myself as far as confidence and being in control of what the bike's going to do.
Yeah.
Ever since I bought that DCT. And I never really felt that confident. Even though I love my old bike, it wasn't like this. That technology just lit my world up. I mean, I just love it. I love what they do.
Yeah, I love the technology, and I'm hoping that when I get a chance to ride across country, I'm absolutely sure, or most likely, I'm gonna probably take the 21 with me.
Yeah, you should.
Yeah,
I think that would be a good choice. And Fred Rao, not Fred Rao. Why did I say that? Fred Harmon.
Yeah, Fred.
First start with Fred, right? They're both my friends. Fred Harmon had mentioned that, he has a very good relationship with the people in Japan that developed this Goldwing, and he talks to them fairly often and gives them a lot of feedback, which is very helpful for them. And some of that feedback comes from people like us and the consumers out there. They listen to everything.
Right.
And what I wanted to make a point of is he said that this is kind of the first time where they've committed that every year they're going to continue to make this bike better and better because they're behind this bike so much. I mean, this has always been their flagship motorcycle. But in this day and age, they've really, really gotten passionate with this model and they realize how good it is. And they're going to continue. That's why you've got the big trunk. They're going to continue to keep enhancing this bike, which I like to hear.
Right.
And they're listening. They're going to continue to make more changes. And all it's doing is keeping them on top, like so far out ahead of everybody else. And I'm really happy on what they're doing. They're staying proactive. And, when Honda designs something, they usually do a really good job.
Yeah.
You mentioned about, first year bikes. I think out of all the companies, I would definitely be more comfortable and feel confident buying a first year bike from Honda than probably any other brand because they do their homework and they're very conservative. Yeah. A lot of other companies tend to push something out a little faster where Honda takes longer than we want. They don't change things fast enough, but as a result of that, they usually get it right.
And remember, Rick, that's why, and like I told you at the beginning of this podcast, is that that's why I selected the Honda Goldwing in the beginning because of his reputation. I didn't know anybody that had a Honda Goldwing. I knew about the Honda Goldwing, but I didn't know anybody personally at that time that had a Honda Goldwing. So my decision was just based off the Honda reputation, and you know, and it turned out to be a winner, and I absolutely love it. And shout, and you mentioned Fred. Shouts out to Fred Hammond. Is it Fred Hammond?
Fred Harmon.
Fred Harmon. Man, he got some great videos. Yes, you know, if you go to YouTube and check out some of his videos, he's very thorough. He explains it.
And we sell his maintenance series too. So, you know, the maintenance videos, which is like a visual shop manual.
Okay.
They're all on WingStuff. We sell all of it. And nowadays it's a streaming service. So when you buy it, you have the rights to stream it anytime you want. Mm-hmm. And you've got all those maintenance videos right there to help you. It's amazing what he's done.
As a matter of fact, I watched his video on how to install the home link on the new Goldwing.
Yeah, we pushed that out. Do you know we sold so many after he did that? He cut the time down from like 9 hours to like 2 hours to install.
I mean,
that.
He did a great job because, you know, at the time, you know, I was wanting the home link, you know, for my garage, you know, to be able to open the door. And I got on YouTube and I found his video, and he did an amazing job just showing how to install that home link. So I said, well, let me buy one. Well, when I tried to find it, no one had it in stock. I couldn't find it anywhere. Even the dealership was out of it. But so I end up changing out my garage motor, and it allows me to connect to my cell phone. So now I don't have to use the home link. I can just let my garage up off of my phone. Okay. But at the time when I purchased my Goldwing, I was actually looking for that home link, and I saw Fred's video, and he did an amazing job. So shouts out to Fred. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, he's been a friend of mine for so many years, and he is, I'll tell you what, he is the authority on this bike. Nobody knows more technical information and has mechanical abilities better than Fred Harmon. He is absolutely the best. And we teamed up and we created this video series along with him. And we have, as you know, podcast episodes with Fred that we do together. And we do do-it-yourself maintenance videos with him. And they're all on our WingStuff YouTube channel. And we want to show people how to change your oil. We did a video on that with Fred, and Fred shows you how to do the oil change and how to, you know, synchronize your DCT clutch, which is another thing that I wanted to mention to people with the DCT every once in a while. It's a synchronization process. And if you watch our video on YouTube, it was a video that Fred had done with us. And Fred shows you how to resync your clutch. And when you first get the bike, it should be all synced up occasionally. Maybe it might be off a little bit, but as you ride your bike and you get thousands of miles on it, if you do this procedure, it will resync your DCT clutch and it'll make it shift even smoother. And once you do that, if you do it a few more times shortly after that, you won't notice much of a difference because it stays in sync for quite a long time. But that's made a big difference. I did mine, and I think I had almost 4,000 miles on my bike when I did it, and it made a big difference.
Yeah.
And since then, I did it again, and it didn't make that much of a difference. So it's really good now. But boy, after I did that procedure, and I wouldn't have known how to do that. You know, Fred did the whole thing on how to do that. You know,
so, I've looked into that. As a matter of fact, I've had to do my bike. Generally, what happens? The clutch plates wear. So as the bike, you know, as you ride it and the bike gets older, the clutch plates wear, and you have to reinitialize the.
Goes out of adjustment. And when it shifts, it's a little bit rougher and people don't realize that. Yeah.
And you may have to do that when you change the oil, because the same oil in the Honda Goldwing, not only that it lubricates the engine, it lubricates the clutch plates. It's the same oil.
True.
So when you change your oil, you may have to reinitialize your Goldwing. Yeah. And let me add this in that a lot of people may not know. If you pull a trailer, and, you know, a lot of people don't pull trailers with the new Goldwing. Well, I'm an avid trailer puller. I pull trailers everywhere I go. Well, when you connect that trailer to your new Goldwing, it may feel like the trailer's trying to pull you back. It may feel like it's not enough power. So what you do is you reinitialize the transmission
or the clutch.
You reinitialize the clutch, and then it you can't tell it's back there. So that's one tip that a lot of people may not know. Or if they decide to get a trailer And that trailer feels like my bike is not strong enough. You reinitialize the clutch and then you're back to normal again.
That's great advice. And what we call it clutch resynchronization is what it is.
Yep.
And, you know, for all of you people with the DCT, what we're talking about is, and you can never do it too many times, by the way. So don't be afraid of that. We've had people ask us, well, if I do it too many times, I'm going to mess something up. No, not at all. Basically what you're doing is you're tuning up, but you're resynchronizing your DCT clutch. And when you run that process, and it's a whole process, you got to push a button a couple of times, you do all this, and it's all explained on the video. So just go to our WingStuff YouTube channel and find that video, and Fred will show you how to do it. And it's a simple thing. It only takes not even 5 minutes to do it. What a difference it makes. So when you guys are riding the DCTs, if you haven't done it yet, at least do it now. Just do it so that you know that it's done. And then in the future, I agree with Chris. I'd probably do it every time I change my oil. And and by doing that, it keeps that perfectly synchronized. Now, if it gets out, like he said, you'll feel like it might shift a little bit, not rough, but it's not going to be as smooth. The trailer, I agree with that. You know, definitely resynchronize your DCT clutch. I would do it like every 4,000 or 5,000 miles myself, but is that too much? Probably more often than you need to do it, but why not do it anyway? Keep the thing perfect all the time.
Yeah. You know, just drive, neutral.
There you go. So we got some good like tips for you guys.
Yeah.
These people out there probably never even heard of that.
They don't even know. They don't have a clue. But if you pull
and some of the other guys are out, some of the other guys are like, yeah, we know that. Okay. But you know that, but not everybody.
Right. But if you pull a trailer, you want to know it because, you know, that trailer may feel like it's pulling you back and you may have to reinitialize that clutch or resync. And then you're good.
Absolutely.
To go. Yep.
And you can never do it too much. And it's a simple process.
It's really simple.
Right. And so, you know, another thing you mentioned, Phobos. So, you know, we sell those, the TPMS, the tire pressure monitoring system from Phobo, one of our best sellers. We sell it all the time. They work great. It goes right to your phone. Tell me some of the experience you had with that, because you had some comments you wanted to make on that Phobo.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, when it first came out, you had some problems with it at first.
It's kind of a long story, but it's not a long story. I've never heard of Phobo. One of my friends, Jason, who I ride with, he was telling me about. But okay, the problem we was having is on the previous generation Goldwing. What happens when the battery inside of that wheel sensor goes down, and it eventually is going to go down, it makes your tire pressure monitoring light stays on. So, you know, he has the 17 or 16, and I have the 16, but both of our bikes are the same. And we had the same problem with our lights staying on. So, you know, make a long
story. This is with the factory TPMS.
This is the factory. So, he had told me, he said, man, I'm going to disable my tire pressure monitoring and I'm going to add Phobo. And I'm like, what is that? And he was explaining it to me. So to make a long story short, I went out and bought the Phobo. You know, I didn't know anything about it. I bought it. I tried them out and they worked fine. Well, a couple of other friends that I have, they said they had a bad experience with Phobo. Well, come to find out, they had the previous or the earlier model Phobos, but the new Phobo 2 uses Bluetooth 5.0, which has It has greater connectivity and a greater range. So I installed the Phobos on my 2016. I was so impressed that I actually installed it on the 21. And I'm so impressed that I just ordered two more boxes. So
that's awesome.
You know, and one for each trailer. So you can put those things on your vehicle. You can put them on your trailer. Yeah. You can put them on your motorcycle. You can monitor your tire pressure in real time. And I even bought the T-valves from WingStuff. That way you can put Phobos on one end and you don't have to take the sensors off to put air in the tire.
Air in the tire. That's correct.
So, I ordered those from WingStuff on those T-valves. So for the previous generation Goldwings that do not have tire pressure monitoring, the T-valves are the way to go. If the bike already has tire pressure monitoring, if you add the T-valves, then you're going to lose you're going to lose your stock sensor because you got to take the stock sensor out.
Right.
So, but on my newer Goldwing, I didn't add the T-valves. I just screwed them on the valve stem to supplement the current tire pressure monitoring. But the takeaway, the takeaway of my story is that the Phobo works great. I've even did a video. You guys can check it out. Riding down the highway, disconnecting a Phobo in real time and reconnecting it just to see would it reconnect. Because when you're parked in a garage and you're doing the connections, you know, everything is perfect. But when you get out on the road, that's your real test. I took the Phobos out on the highway. I turned off my Bluetooth. I turned off the Phobo app. I reconnected the Bluetooth, turned back on the Phobo app. Resync. Tire pressure pops up in real time. Absolutely perfect. And I love it so much. I done bought a total of 4 boxes.
That's awesome.
And those things are $100 a box.
Yeah.
No, that's awesome. Worth it. But they're working.
That newer version has been out for a while, and it's one of our best sellers. I really like the Phobo myself. It works great, like you said, and it's a safety thing that I think everybody should have. I mean, if they don't have a tire pressure monitoring system on their bike, I recommend they do, because you don't want to find out you have a flat tire the hard way when you're going down the road and you have your wife or girlfriend on the back and your bike is starting to, you know, go all over the road, and you just realize that you're getting a flat tire and you got to get over to the side of the road. I want to know ahead of time.
And
TPMS to me is one of the greatest inventions. I like having it on my bike. I like to know what's going on with my tires.
So right.
I'm glad you mentioned that.
Yeah. You can't beat the Phobos. You got to have it.
I agree with you. On that subject, are there any other accessories that you really like? What else is, one of your favorite things that you've put on your bike?
On my 2016, I put all the accessories on there that I could pretty much put on there. And I came back and did the same thing to the 21. So, for me, when it comes to accessories, I choose function over form. A lot of guys like chrome because it looks good. And I do like chrome, but for me, it has to do something. It can't just look good. So the accessories that I install on my Goldwing, they have to actually serve a purpose. Sometimes they happen to be chrome accented, but it has to be a light, or it has to serve some type of function. So which accessories that I like on the newer Goldwing, I recently just added the Gold Strike Zero wireless phone charger. And
I have that on absolutely my bike great. Too. I so love it.
If you have the new phone, like I have the iPhone 13, you just drop it right in the cradle charges. And it automatically charges the phone. So I really love that on my new Goldwing. So much so that on my 2016, I was using the Karayakin large, what they call the perch mount. I took that off and put back another Gold Strike charger. Now, it's not wireless, but it's the same cradle. And it absolutely holds the phone. It doesn't. I've even had it where I didn't have it screwed down tight enough and the cradle turned upside down. And when I got to my destination and I looked, my phone was actually upside down, still in the cradle, but it never fell out. So I love all of the Gold Strike accessories. The ring of fire on the front, the Gold Strike grips on the newer Goldwing. Like I said, the grips get hotter than the previous generation Goldwing. Now, on my previous generation Goldwing, I installed those ISO grips in the past. Well, what happened is it cuts the heat. You know, it doesn't really get as hot once you cover the grips with those ice with the Karayakin ISO grips. But with the Gold Strike, once I put those on my 21 Goldwing, it still gets fire hot. I mean, you don't lose any heat.
They did a better job of transferring the heat through the grip to your hands. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Arrow's a smart guy, you know. Arrow owns Gold Strike, and he's a friend of mine. And boy, I'll tell you, he's done some amazing things with some of the products he's come out. Yeah. I have that wireless charger on my bike too.
I
love it. I have the new trunk light that has all the functionality on your phone, and you can do everything with it. I mean, it's just, you know, we're a big fan of Gold Strike. It's our biggest brand. And right. I happen to love the people behind the brand too. We've had right. a long relationship for many, many years. And yeah, they make some very nice accessories for your bike.
Yeah, that trunk, like, matter of fact, just came out probably in the last 2 or 3 weeks that I'm aware of. Now, you might have got it came out
before that. Matter of fact, we were introduced to it at Sturgis in last August, and I had my Goldwing there, and they installed it on my bike. It's the trunk light that goes on the back. It has all functionality, all different functionalities with your phone. You can make it flash when you hit your brake. It'll do all kinds of patterns. You can change the colors. You can, there's all right. kinds of things you can do to it. Yeah. That came out last around, like, it might've come out a little bit before that, but I believe around last August, and they put it on my bike.
I stand corrected. They made it for the 18, but they didn't make it for the 21.
Oh, that's correct. But they will. They're going to change the wire harness.
It's out now. It just came out. It just came out. And that's what I guess I was speaking on my 21. You were speaking of your 18. They made it for the 18, yes. but it just came out for the 21. And it gives you the functionality on the phone to change it and all of that. So right. I've also added the Gold Strike passenger armrest. And one of the reasons, Rick, why I went with the Gold Strike passenger armrest is because it allows you to put the Gold Strike large cup holder on that armrest, because, you know, they make several, you know, I think Rivco makes the armrest. There's a couple of different manufacturers that make armrests. But I went with Gold Strike because Gold Strike allows me to put the cup holder back there. Because the other armrest does not. I mean, you can put some more armrests, but you won't have a place for cup holders. So I went with the Gold Strike for that cup holder. So shouts out to Gold Strike for the cup holder, for the armrest, for the, the ring of fire, for the grips, for the cup holder. I mean, I love my Gold Strike products. I really love to go. My next project is to add the those filler lights that goes on the back. Now, I know you have them on your bike because I've seen them on the very back there with the license plates that fills that gap.
Yes. So the lights that come down like this.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. The vertical lights. So, you know, I'm going to get those next. I'm saving up. I'm going to get those next. So, but shouts out to Gold Strike. They make some great accessories. And Gold Strike, if you're watching this video, send me some accessories so I can install them.
You know, when I rendezvoused with them in Sturgis, we had planned to do a makeover on my bike, and we actually finished my 2018, because when I first bought my 2018 that year, I met them over in Arizona. They were at a rally over in Arizona. And so they didn't have all the accessories out at the time. So they put everything they had on my bike at the time when I went to the rally. It was a Harley rally in Arizona. And now I went to Sturgis in 2021, and they put all the rest of the accessories that I wanted on my bike. So they totally did a makeover and accessorized my bike. And it was the wireless charger. It was the light for the trunk on the back that we talked about with the multifunctionality. Yep. And I mean, that thing even has a brake light. You know, you buy these brake modulators. You don't even need a brake modulator. If you buy the light, everything's programmed in the light. You just program it. Yeah. But you're right about that. So mine's been out since 2018, but the 21 version just came out because they had to modify the wire harness because Honda changed the wiring on the 2021. That's why the previous version didn't work. So now we're selling them and everybody's buying them up like crazy. So I agree with you with the Gold Strike stuff. Shouts out to you, Errol. I mean, what a great job he did. I'm so proud to see what he's done. And it's just making our ride even more comfortable. And that's what it does. I mean, you know, comfort stuff I love. I'm like you. I like bling. I love bling. I do. I have to admit. But I like functional stuff, too. The first things I put on my bike were the Gold Strike highway pegs. And then I put a driver backrest. I happened to go with the Utopia on my bike. And then later I ended up getting a Corbin seat. So now that has the backrest built into it, you know, but what a great job. And they have more stuff coming out all the time.
Yeah. You know, and one more thing, let me say this to the people that's watching this, this podcast. If anybody's out there that wants to get into motorcycling, just note, there's nothing cheap about motorcycling. All the accessories, all of the gear, all of the bells and the whistles. You're going to always see something you want for your bike. There's never an end.
Never end.
You're going to always see something you want, and it's not going to be cheap. So cheap and motorcycles does not go in the same sense.
Right.
You're going to always see something you want. You know, I thought I was done here recently, and Phobo.
You're never done.
Yes, it's always something. It's always something. And I haven't even added that new light that, from Gold Strike yet. Shouts out to Char out there at Niehaus Cycle Sales out there in Illinois. She the one that called me, actually, and said that, hey, Chris, we got the Gold Strike light in.
It came in, and I was like, wow,
how much is it? Well, you told me the price. I was like, oh, I got this. I'm going to have to save up on that one.
Well, you want good stuff? You know, the only time you complain, well, not me, but I don't complain because I know better, but the only time anybody complains about quality is when they first buy it. And they never complain again because they never have a problem with it.
Right. That's right. You pay for what you get. You pay for what you get. And so just note, you know, when you get into cycling, or if you already have a motorcycle, or if you're going to buy a Goldwing or any motorcycle for that matter, it's expensive, and you're going to always want to add these accessories. So I still have a list of things, even out there, all of the accessories that I've added on both of my bikes, over 1,000 videos. I still have a list of accessories that I need to get, like the Ghost Strike trunk light. So, you know, it is what it is, but just note that nothing is cheap about motorcycling.
Yeah, it's like if you buy a Lamborghini and you go to buy something for it and it's expensive. Right. Don't complain about it. You have a Lamborghini, you know, and the Goldwing is such an incredible motorcycle. And some of this stuff costs some money, but boy, look what you're getting. So stop complaining. Yes. You bought the best motorcycle on the planet. Yes. Do you want to put garbage on your bike, or do you want high quality stuff? And you're going to have to pay. It's not free. There's cost of materials too.
Yeah, and that's what I do. I mean, I constantly add accessories on my bike, and it's just it's never ending. But you know, once the good thing about it, I always tell people, once you buy it, you got it.
You know, once you
make that purchase, it's done. So just note that there's nothing cheap about it. And if you want some good products, I highly recommend WingStuff.
I appreciate that.
Probably 90% of the accessories on my bike come from WingStuff. You know, if you need something for your Goldwing, even if it's the previous model Goldwing or the new Goldwing, go to WingStuff. I think it's wingstuff.com and put in your bike year. Hit that search button. And if you need something for your Goldwing, it's there. It's there. I even bought the for my 2016, I bought the brake pads for the front and the back.
Right.
Because they do not sell them at the Honda dealer like that. They sell them they sell them front or back. But at WingStuff, I was able to get the front and back as a combo.
Yes.
And it was actually cheaper. So I did that several times. So I shop at WingStuff quite a lot.
Good.
Yes,
well,
sir.
Well, I'm glad. And I hope we're earning your business, and I hope we're doing a good job for you, because we really try our best and we love what we do.
Yes, sir.
This is my 23rd year since I started WingStuff. And I started working in a Honda dealership when I was a 16-year-old kid. And here I am. I'm still doing what I love to do. And I started WingStuff way back in like 1999. I started WingStuff, and I don't regret any of it. Every day I love what I do. I still love what I do. And that's the difference. We really have a passion, and the people that you know, work for our company the same way, we have a real good thing. But I'm glad that you enjoy our website, and we're always trying to make it the best it can be. And, but thank you for that. And if we ever screw up, watch how fast I fix something. We're human too.
I even bought my first set of Dunlop E4s for my 2014, or was it 2016? I bought those at WingStuff. You can probably pull up my purchase history, Rick. And man,
I
get a lot of stuff from WingStuff, man. And the good thing about it, you know, well, here in Tennessee, in about 3 days or so, you'll have it. Yeah. So, you know, I appreciate that. And if they, like Rick said, if they mess up on an order or something is not right, they'll make it right. Yeah. No problem at all. Just call them and they'll fix that. And that's important nowadays.
Yeah.
But, you know, I call it, you know, service after the sale. Anybody could sell you a product. But what happens after you purchase it? Could you call that company back and say, hey, I have a problem? you know, would they allow a return? So that's one of the things I love about WingStuff is the customer service is top notch. If you got an issue, they will make it right. They will make it right.
And we do. And thank you for saying
that. That's very important.
Yeah. I mean, we love you guys. We're out there trying to make you guys happy. We're not just some corporate company that decided to sell Goldwing accessories. I've been doing this since I was a kid in the motorcycle business. You know, 16 years old, I worked in a Honda dealership and I love what I do. And here we are doing this podcast. And I can tell you, I love it just as much now as I ever did before, probably more so. Yeah. And I mean, we like helping people. It's not just about selling things. It's doing what we enjoy, and we're helping people, and we have a community on our site. We have 148,000 active members on WingStuff. We actually calculated every time somebody signs up for a profile on our website, you know, it the counter clicks up one. And, you know, it's not just about numbers. It's about just trying to treat people right and giving them, I'm not reading from a cue card, giving them the kind of service that you would love to have. I mean, you know, I was you guys. I mean, I try to help everybody, and we do a good job at that. And I appreciate that. And like I said, if we ever messed up, watch how fast I fix it. I mean, we are human, but we do a pretty good job. We have the biggest inventory we've ever had in the history of the company. We have a big warehouse in San Clemente out here in Southern California, and we're able to stock a lot of product, especially in the times that we're running out of things because of the shortages with COVID and stuff. There's a lot of inventory problems with stores not getting things. So lately we've been going so deep on inventory on things that we don't want to run out of, because often the manufacturer is going to continue to run out because of the supply chain problems with transportation from the countries that are producing this stuff. So we've had to battle that by just stocking deeper on product so that the times in between when they are backward, we still have plenty on our shelf. So tires are one of those things, you know, we're stocking more tires than we ever have in history. Right. And it's a lot of money to tie up, but we're doing it because we don't want to be out of tires, because there was a period of time where it was almost 4 months that nobody had tires because they couldn't get the boats in. They're all out in the Pacific, all lined up trying to come in, and COVID has created all these things. So, you know, we're always doing our best to do, you know, whatever we can to help you guys and give you guys the best shopping experience. But with that said, a lot of people might not realize, you know, our site is really a community social media, if you want to say, based core at the site. Right. You know, everybody has their photo gallery, any product reviews that they do on the site shows up in their profile, any blog comments shows up there. You know, they have an avatar picture, they get loyalty rewards, every dollar they spend. You know, our platinum members are getting 5% back on every dollar they spend, and they can use that for future purchases. I mean, you know, that's something that's a no-brainer. It's like, you know, I'm taking money out of my pocket, but I'm rewarding you for spending money with us. So the more money you spend, if you get into that third tier, and it doesn't take very long to get into it, you're getting 5% back on every dollar you spend besides the discount prices. So, you know, just for not even trying to sell ourselves, just making people aware of what we try to do to help you guys. We know some of this stuff can be expensive, and we do our very best to keep our prices as low as we can, and giving people incentives by incentivizing them. The more they spend, the more money that they get back to buy more stuff. So, you know, we try to do everything that we can too, you know? Yeah.
And another thing that I, you know, you didn't probably was unaware of this, but with the, for me, when I shop at WingStuff website, one thing you have that sometimes other websites don't have, you guys will give the part number. So a lot of times you may be looking for a part, and you know, a lot of times they don't want to give you the part number because you can look it up and find it somewhere else. That's one of the things I do like about WingStuff is the part number is there, and you can get that part number. So you can get that part number, you can buy it there, or you can, you know, wherever you want to buy it. So that's one of the things I do really like about, and I've never even told anybody that. I never mentioned that, but, you know, come to think of it, I'll, you know, shop and I noticed that part number is there. If I can't remember, like, what's that part number? And then I'll go to WingStuff. There it is. So,
you know, we're very transparent. We want to show you guys everything. We're very transparent and we're very confident in our pricing. Yeah. I mean, we do. We discount very aggressively. And for the service that we offer everybody, I mean, a lot of the guys that work for us, they're great guys. I mean, they have families. You've got quality people that you're talking to on the phones. Now, the last thing I would ever do is put somebody from overseas on my phones to take your order. And do you have a part number, sir? And you ask them a question. They have no idea how to answer you or how to fix your problem. No, you got real people on our phones that know this stuff. And so, you know, we like you, we live and breathe this. We love what we do.
Right. And you know, and I'm speaking from the heart, man. You know, just like here a few years ago, I bought the ride off center stand from you guys.
Yeah.
You know, that was the first time I ever bought one, and I put it on my Honda Go, on my 2016 Honda Go Wing. I haven't looked back, and that ride off center stand is amazing. And I like it so much so that when I bought my new Go Wing, I went right back to Wing Stuff and I bought a second ride off center stand and I put it on. So it's just things like that, man. You know, just being able to, because sometimes websites and things shut down, Wing Stuff is still there. You know, they've improved the website. You can get whatever you need for your motorcycle, for your Honda Goldwing. And it's a great help for the Goldwing community. Yeah.
Thank you. And I take that as a compliment. We've worked really hard, but I appreciate that you see the things that we've done, and we continue to do that stuff. We're always enhancing that site and the community side of that site. Boy, we've really done a good job. We've been fine tuning that since, you know, the early 2000s. And there's a lot of intuitive stuff on that website that help you make your shopping experience easy. I mean, it's a real cutting edge site, and the security is, we have so much security on there. You know, the only thing we get is your last four digits. We don't even get your credit card number. I mean, talk about security. You know, I that site has always been a priority. We're always trying to, you know, improve and secure the site. And I'm glad you like it. We're very proud.
I bought my trunk carpet. When I bought my new Goldwing, I bought trunk carpet, saddlebag carpet, bought it at Wing Stuff. And the thing I liked about it, you sold the Honda OEM carpet. Right. You had the Wing Stuff version. Yeah. And I can't remember if there was a third version, but there was a selection of different carpets for the Goldwing. Yes. So, you know, I bought that at Wing Stuff. So, you know, there's things like that I may never really mention in my videos, but believe it or not, Wing Stuff is where I get a lot of my accessories from. A lot of my
That makes me feel good. I feel like I'm doing something right then. Thank you.
You are. Trust me. Thank you, man. Thank you.
And that carpet, that was my little project. You know, I'm very proud of that carpet, because what we did is this new Goldwing, you know, it's so nice. And we looked at the OEM carpets, and the quality was nice on OEM, but the price was really expensive. Right. And even though we sell those in discount, and we decided to do carpets again, and we always search out. And so I had all these different samples, and we ended up getting the best quality carpets that we could find out there. And it's like less than half the price of the OEM. Right. But look at the quality of our carpet.
Yes.
Put it next to the OEM carpet that's so expensive. Right. And ours, if it's not as good, it's better. It's beautiful, beautiful quality. Not junky carpet, you know. Right. Beautiful.
I had a choice to get either one. I said, do I get the Honda OEM or do I get the Wing Stuff? I chose the Wing Stuff. The more I think about it, Rick, I could go on about so many accessories that I bought from
Wing Stuff. We won't tie time up on that.
One more, Rick. All I bought my Goldwing cover. So anytime I travel, I cover my Goldwing with the cover. I bought my Goldwing cover from Wing Stuff. I see a lot of guys have the half covers. I know you guys sell those. But this one, this was the big full cover, waterproof. It came with a bag. The first cover for my bike, bought from Wing Stuff. So, you know, you guys are awesome. So
keep up the
good work, man. Keep up the
good work. Thank you. We tried. And that cover, again, we searched out all the different materials. That is really waterproof. It really is waterproof.
It is. It is. Yeah. I could go on, Rick. I bought my bra.
Thank you.
I brought the bra from a 2016 from Wingstone. Right. Sure did.
Well, thank you for all the compliments. You're making me blush, but you know, I appreciate it. You know, we always try. We don't want to just offer you guys anything. Like we talked about before, you get what you pay for. And, you know, we try to offer you guys some nice quality stuff. I don't want to sell anything with my name on it that I'm not proud of. So thanks for noticing that our products are so nice, because we do a lot of work, you know, with suppliers overseas, you know, choosing and picking. And believe me, some of the stuff isn't as nice, but it's cheap. And right. You know what? If it's too cheap, I don't want it.
Right.
I don't want it.
Right.
So thanks for realizing the value in what we do. So
yes.
That's great, you know.
Yeah.
But so you know, this has been a
if a lot of people want to know the strength behind Caliente, you're looking at it wing stuff. So I get a lot of my
there
stuff.
You go.
I get a lot of my stuff there, like you know, Superman. Where did he get his power from?
There you go.
You know, with me, a lot of my majority of my accessories come from wing stuff. And I'm not being paid to say this. No one is paying me to say this or anything. I'm speaking from the heart. They make good products. Anything you need for your Honda Goldwing, I highly recommend Wing Stuff. I'm on that site at least several times a week, at least.
Thank you very much.
Every time
and that's a compliment to our whole staff because it's the whole team there. And you know, we really enjoy what we do and we like helping people on the phone and people call us all the time. And we're always helping people and recommending things because they don't know. They have questions.
Right.
And
right.
The nice thing is you could call us and ask questions. We love answering them. You know, whereas a lot of companies are so corporate and robotic that you're just dealing with an operator. You can't ask her anything. And, you know, even when you go to some of these marketplaces online, it's like an online vending machine. You can't call them. You can't ask questions. And so, you know, we're doing something that we love to do. So thank you for noticing. And I appreciate that. We've always tried to support the Goldwing community. And I've had a special place, even though I worked many years ago before I started Wing Stuff. I worked in a Honda dealership and I was dealing with all the different Honda motorcycles because like you, I'm a motorcyclist. I like all types of motorcycles, but I always had this thing for the Goldwing and we did at that dealership too. And I'm glad that when I came out here from Rhode Island, because that's where I grew up and I was in the motorcycle business in Rhode Island growing up after high school, I ended up pursuing it and I ran a dealership out here in California for about 10 years. And then the owner had retired. And that's when I started Wing Stuff. When the owner of the dealership that I was managing here in California decided to retire, I started WingStuff.com back in 1999. And I never looked back. And it's been a great ride. And I still love it. And I get to talk to people like you and meet a lot of folks. I mean, I travel sometimes. You know, last year, it was funny. I was in an airport and I had these guys come up to me and they go, "Is that you, Count Ricula?" And I'm looking at him because we did a Halloween scary deal sale. And we did this remake of Young Frankenstein and it was black and white. And it was, you know, like maybe a 10-minute, you know, video. And it was just really fun. And this guy had got such a kick out of it. He saw me at the airport. I don't know who he is. He's one of our customers. And, he's calling me, "Hey, Count Ricula." And he's shaking my hand. And, you know, it's just great that people enjoy some of that stuff that we do, you know.
Awesome.
We might as well have fun at what we do, right?
Exactly. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, it is. Mm-hmm. So with that, I guess we'll start trying to wrap up here and talk about fun. I can't tell you how much fun it was to have you as a guest today. This was really a lot of fun for me. I think everybody out there enjoyed it too. And, you know, if any of the folks out there, if you haven't seen Chris's YouTube channel, I would encourage you to go check it out because it's great. I mean, I've always enjoyed watching his videos, and that's what prompted me to call him the other day and say, "Hey, Chris, it's Rick from Wing Stuff. How'd you like to be a special guest on our WingCast podcast series?" And he was on board, and I knew he was a customer of ours for years. I had looked up in our system. So yeah. I would encourage you folks to go check out his YouTube channel. He's got some good stuff out there, good information that can help you guys out. And I think you're just going to love watching his videos anyway. And it's on YouTube and it's under Chris Caliente. And we're going to have a link to that in the description on this podcast and video that we're doing here today on this episode. So I would encourage all you guys to sign up for him, you know, give him thumbs up if it's on Facebook and like his YouTube videos and let's support this guy because boy, he's doing a great job and he's out there having fun. And I just want to do everything I can to let people know about him because, you know, you're a good guy, Chris. And I really enjoyed not only talking to you, but your channel and I love what you do. And it's just fun talking to you. You're just a great guy.
If you want to see videos on how to's, if you want to see some good riding vlogs, you want to see some good traveling, some good, clean comedy, some good, clean fun.
A
good group of guys, the Caliente, Goldwing Riders, a good group of guys. Check out my YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button and also hit that like button. And also you can follow me on Facebook, the Chris Caliente Facebook group, the hottest Facebook group in the land.
There you go. I support it. You guys are great.
Appreciate
you. So all you guys out there, please go check out his YouTube channel. I think you're going to really enjoy it. It's just pure good stuff. What can I tell you? It's just fun watching. So, and now that, you know, we had this, this episode here, I think people got to know you a little bit more up close and personal. And certainly some of your YouTube fans are watching this right now. So hello to all of them. And for all you new guys, subscribe to his YouTube channel and, you know, like him and let's support his effort because he's doing a great job taking this time, sharing his experiences and all his fun and his tips and all this stuff with all of you. And sometimes that's a lot of work. So we want to give back to you, Chris. So
thank you.
I can't thank you enough for joining me on the channel. We covered a lot of stuff and I truly enjoyed this and we're going to invite you back as a guest again in the future because I'd love to do that again.
That would be great. That would be great. And thanks for having me, Rick. I appreciate it.
All right. So with that, we're going to close now. So you take care, Chris. And for all of you out there at home, thank you for watching this episode of WingCast. And we look forward to doing another episode with Chris in the near future and seeing what's going on with him. And we will check back with him. So go ahead and check out his YouTube channel and go ahead and see him on Facebook. And for now, I'm just going to tell all you guys to be careful, ride safe, check your tires, everybody. Check your tires.
Check
the rear tire that nobody wants to check because it's more work. But anyway.
And if you're lazy, get the Phobos.
That's right. Don't forget about that Phobo TPMS. But anyway, Chris, thank you so much. And all you folks out there, ride safe. And thanks for joining us on this episode. So take care.
Thanks, Rick.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Well, I feel like checking on Uncle Frank. We'll see how he's doing. And we'll have a little hey with Uncle Frank now. So let's give him a quick call.
Hello.
Hey, Uncle Frank.
Yeah, what do you want now?
Hey, we're doing another podcast episode, so I figured I'd check in with you again.
Yeah, all right. What do you want to do?
Just calling to say hi again. That's all. See how
you're doing. All right. I didn't know. We didn't eat yet. He's just going to order in about a half hour.
Oh, what are you going to have for dinner?
I don't know. Spaghetti, maybe. I don't know, Rick. I don't know. It don't matter to me what the hell we have anyway.
As long as it has tomato sauce on it, right?
I don't care. It doesn't matter what I eat.
That's the Italian tradition.
Yeah, so, you know. Well, if it is, it is. I don't care, Rick. It don't matter.
Now, George and I have been discussing the idea of
Why are you mumbling? You're mumbling on the phone.
No, I'm not mumbling. Listen. George and I were discussing getting you some kind of a pet.
Rick, what the hell is wrong with you?
Do you want a pet?
No, what the hell's the matter with you? You want a pet? At my age, I want a pet. What's wrong with you?
Well, we were thinking about getting you something like that stands on all fours like a dog.
Were you trying to be funny now, or you want to really talk to me or not?
No,
you want to talk to me, or you want to fool around?
All right, listen. We were just talking about maybe you'd like to have a pet. If you don't want a dog.
For what? Okay. What the hell do I want anybody for?
All right, a dog, not a person.
If he wants to get one, it's up to him if he wants one.
All right, well, it certainly doesn't sound like you want a pet.
No, I don't. What the hell do I want a pet for?
Okay, all right. We won't get you one then. I'm just checking.
What do you mean, we? Why? What do you got, Georgie, on the phone, I suppose?
No, George and I were discussing, you know, maybe Uncle Frank would be, like, you know, have more company during the day if we bought you a pet.
I want company. I got enough company to take care of myself.
All right.
And you want me to have a puppy? What is wrong
all
with
right.
you, Rick?
All right, listen.
Are you sick of something?
No,
what
no,
you
all
have
right.
to drink today?
All right, listen. I didn't drink at all. You're really a riot today. But listen, say goodbye to everybody. This has been a really funny radio show.
It's a radio show. Goodbye, everybody. It was nice talking to you. My nephew's a little tippy today.
All right,
That's all I can say.
I'm actually just joking around with you, Uncle Frank.
Yeah, I know, I know.
You're a riot, I gotta tell you. You are funny.
Yeah, all right. You're lucky that you're in that place where you are now.
Yeah, I know. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here.
Yeah, I know that.
You bought me my first
motorcycle. I made you a millionaire. I made you.
Oh, I'm not a millionaire by any means. Trust me.
Not yet, anyway.
All right. I'll tell you. All right, Uncle Frank, we're going to let you go, and I'll talk to you later.
Okay, okay, guys. Bye-bye, guys. Bye.
Thanks for listening to WingCast. This has been a WingStuff.com production. Please be sure to rate, review, and subscribe to us wherever you listen to podcasts. Got a question or comment for me? Send an email to WingCast@WingStuff.com, and it could be featured on a future episode. You can also visit WingStuff.com and sign up for our newsletter to stay up to date on the newest podcast episodes, products, videos, Goldwing news, sales, and more. Until next time, I'm Rick Arnoldo. Ride safe.